Welcome to another episode. My name is Julius Afolabi. I'm a premium business coach, a value improvement strategist, and an author. I help skilled and knowledge-based entrepreneurs develop compatible business solutions that are globally competitive and highly paid. Today, our conversation is around money. Money is an inevitable subject, and it's one of the critical factors that determines a lot of things. But the understanding of money varies with different people. Poverty is cruel, but making money is not automatic, right? But what exactly is money? Money is not only the paper, the physical paper that we see most of the time. Money is both paper and practical. The real money actually is your money-making resource. That's the real money that has to be converted and the exchange for the paper money. So if you find a dollar right now, the dollar is not the money. The dollar is just a medium of exchange or the store of the value that you have exchanged for another thing. So, but most importantly, while it might be very difficult to make money, it is much more difficult to manage money. And I always advise that you learn how to manage money before you make money. So how do you manage money? Three simple ways in which you can manage money is, first of all, is to what? Spend to be rich. Learn how to spend to be rich. A lot of people think that your financial stability and confidence comes from how much you earn. That's not true. It's not about how much you have in your bank account. It's not about how much you're paid, but how much you are able to multiply what you earn. Quite a number of people's month is at the end of the money. But what is responsible for this tragedy? It's simply because probably their income is limited compared to their expenses. And it's often said that when your expenses supersede your income, your upkeep will be your downfall. So in managing money, you need to spend to be rich. That is to say, your expenditure creates opportunity for you to make more. And that will only happen when you have financial literacy. It is most of the time financial ignorance that leads towards money problems. So money, poverty is a behavior problem. Are we together? Poverty is a behavior problem. Some people are poor because of their attitude towards money. So it's either you increase your income or you reduce your expenses. But then, how do you spend to be rich? Simple, what do you buy? Do you buy because you can afford it, or it is simply what you need? There are a lot of things that you can afford, but you don't need. So if you are expending on pleasure instead of investing in assets, that would mean that what you are preparing yourself for bankruptcy. Now, Mike Tyson at 20 earned so much in several billions, but in less than 2 years, he ran bankrupt. Why? Because of an extravagant lifestyle. So that's why we said poverty is a money, it's a behavior issue, right? So you can be money poor. Some people are not broke, but they are poor. Being broke is not that you don't have money, but you don't know how to manage money. You understand? But being poor is that you don't have money behaviors. How are we together? So it's either you increase your income or you reduce your expenses. And how do you spend to be rich? Avoid debt or properly manage your debt. There are times when you would have to borrow. Nobody's exempted from borrowing, right? Because of emergencies, because of inevitabilities and necessities. The moment you cannot meet up with your necessities and inevitabilities, it means that what? You will be under financial pressure. There are a lot of things domestically that will not announce to you before they happen. For instance, you can just wake up in the morning and your gas is finished. right? But if you are a careful person, you would have understood how long it takes for your gas to finish and then be able to prepare a budget for it. So a budget is a software against poverty. So but the problem is that people lack the discipline to keep a budget. It's not budgeting, it's the discipline of keeping the budget that helps you manage your funds. And not all debts are bad, right? If you are undertaking a debt, understand that it is a loan, not a dash. So with that in mind, you are to use your debt not for consumption, but to multiply your ability to earn more, right? And then another thing is be conscious of the investments. A lot of people today are poor because they entered into wrong investments. And today, scams have claimed a lot of lives. A lot of people are also involved in some forms of money deficiency habits like gambling, right? Gambling gets you addicted to spending without making what you spend. Statistics have it like 60% of those that gamble never recover their funds. So if 60% can't recover their funds, then why should you? It makes no money sense for you to invest in gambling, right? People see it as you can't take a short-term relief that will make you entrapped over a long time. So that short-term relief will only bring you, will enter you into a long-term trap. So you can see that money might be difficult to make. It requires hard work, it requires creativity, it requires visibility as well, because you might, if you are not visible, you might not be able to make more money. But making more money doesn't make you rich. It is managing the money that you make that determines whether you're going to be rich. And why I said money is necessary, but it is not ultimate. At the point, the money you make increase, it would not add to your happiness. You get to a ceiling at a particular point. So it is not how rich you are, but what is the richness of your life. So that's another dimension entirely. A lot of people do a lot of things to make money, but their money have no meaning. So to a large extent, if you can chase money with the totality of your health, and when you get the wealth, you start chasing your health. That means you mismanage yourself. At the same time, it can make you bankrupt. So there are quite a number of things that are involved in the management of money, especially learning to spend to be rich. You don't have to buy what you can afford, buy what you need. What is the criteria for the things you spend your money on? Are they, what's your vision about? What's the long-term effect of what you're doing? Or you want the short-term pleasure that will bring you long-term pressure? So these are the things. How are you multiplying your income channels? Salary today, they say, what do you call it? Minimum wage is maximum frustration. So you've got to determine how you're going to multiply your income channels at the same time. Device means to curtail your expenses, right? To take advantage of economics of scale. So money has a lot of uses, like you know, for transactionary motive, precautionary motive, and then what speculative motive? That's investment, that's management, and that is what income multiplication. For transaction to multiply your income, and then for precautions to save you. That's why you need savings, you need investment, and you need business if you have to increase your income. In managing your money, you need to spend to be rich, you need to invest at the same time, avoid debt, and increase your leverages. So, for now, that's what we'll share with you. In subsequent episodes, we'll talk more about how you can manage your debt so that you don't fall under financial pressure. The name remains Julius Afolabi. You can follow me on my social media.